Welcome back, team. In this video, let us conduct a linear regression analysis. That is a task 2, like similar to task 1. This also contains three different activities. First one is capturing the screen. We create a linear regression model and we capture screen and we paste it onto the document. That's just about the task. Second one is whatever the results that we have generated, that should be kept in table 2.2. That also we directly extract from the results sheet, results that we generate. The third one is we write some description about the values that are extracted. Okay, so this is all about the activity. So first, before understanding these things, let us start explaining about creation of linear regression model in RapidMiner. Okay, so it's a simple, what I do is like I will create simple because here we are not verifying the performance of the model, right? So can also verify it. So let me check that to what extent we do. Take a data set. This is the data set that we have taken. Next, we have the data set. So that is some unnecessary error. Ignore that one. So you just copied and pasted your data set onto the process pane. Then what we do is like we use the select attributes variable. So for example, in the last video, we learned that there are top 5 variables that will be influencing medieval value of the house owners. So if it is mentioned in the, if it is mentioned in the document to select only top 5 correlated values, we use them. But after thorough review of the requirement sheet, it is nowhere mentioned to use only top 5 variables, so we consider all variables. So let us do this and see. When you click on this, it contains all, but if you want some attributes to be selected, so you just click on this one and select subset. When we click on subset, it asks you to select variables. You can select whatever the variables are. As if we need to select only 5 variables, we select those 5 variables. When we click it, only the analysis will be conducted on only those 5 variables. Okay. So, but as it is not mentioned here, we are selecting all function over here. Okay. So thus, when we got all variables, then what we do, we need to identify the target variable out of the sheet. See, when we go, our target variable is MEDV values. I guess if people know about target variable and dependent variable and independent variable. So independent variables will be influencing the dependent variable. So we also call dependent variable as a label or a target variable. So for that purpose, to decide about the target variable, we use set role function. So we use this function and we set some role. So extract to set role. So in this set role, we need to select. So it contains all the attributes of the data set. So in this, middle well is the target variable and we decide it as a label. Okay. So label is a role that is assigned. Means we mention that by doing this activity, it decides that medieval value is the MEDV value is the target variable. And we analyze all other factors to decide about MEDV value. So now we apply linear regression. So we do have set role. So usually if you want to understand the performance of the linear regression function, we need to split data. We will be training the data and we apply training model onto the linear regression model and we generate values and we also generate performance. Okay. So now I don't want to show all those things because it is just asked to generate linear regression model, right? We have nothing to do with the understanding, like identifying how the linear regression model performed. Okay, what I do is like I will just use linear regression model function. So linear regression. This is linear regression function. I'm using it. And extract root trace and I'm generating all outputs, the result, then whatever the data that is given, then weights. So when you run this model, it generates linear regression. Okay, this is significance 0.05 significance. Okay, at 0.05 significance, we are generating this linear regression values. So now you got all the values. See, the way these are the correlating values. Like, see how each and every attribute is it's a common, like, overall correlation means, like, when we consider each and every factor that is in the list, how it is correlated. This value might be different from the value that you achieved in correlation analysis. For example, for iStat, the correlation was around 0.7 something negative correlation. Here it is 0.529. So it is a overall correlation. When we consider all the factors together, how it is correlating with, how it is variating, covariance, you can say covariance, okay? So how it is variating when compared to, when all factors are considered, how it is variating with respect to the target variable. That is, this is weights used in the correlation. Then weights that we use to generate correlation, sorry, linear regression equation. So here you got linear regression table. This table they are asking for, okay? We should copy and paste this table. So what we do, like, if we have p value, t value, we got standard coefficient values. So okay, these are the coefficient values, and so when we write linear regression equation, if you people know about linear regression equation, so means, for example, to predict target, we don't see MEDV value over here, okay? To predict about MEDV, if you want to calculate MEDV, when we have all these values, we can write an equation to generate value of it. That equation will be MEDV is equal to 36.523 minus 0.529 iStat value plus 0.009 black value plus, sorry, minus 0.950 PT ratio plus, in this way you write complete equation and you can generate the value. Got it? So linear regression helps you to predict about the target variable. Next, here the significance of the attribute can be decided based on the p value that is given over here. Okay, so considering this p value, so p value should be always greater than 0.05. when we see this here, ATT1 is a significant value, means it has the ability to decide about the target value. Next, it is index value, it is 0.746, it is also highly significant. In this way, based on the p value we decide. So this is test statistics. Based on this test statistic, we decide p value. Okay, so when we use t statistics, we identify that p value is this, and based on this we can say that attribute one is significant. Means we can use attribute one to decide about the target variable. We got only two variables that are highly significant, showing high significance on the target variable. Most of the values are zeros or lesser than 0.05, or means smaller than 0.05. So that is how we decide. So this coefficient value is how it is variating. For example, in the equation we say that medieval value MEDV is equal to minus 0.002 into this target attribute. It means how covariation, like this speaks of coefficient, speaks about the covariation when we are calculating linear regression equation. Okay, so this is intercept, this is an additional value, what we call slope intercept. Okay, so this is a standard value, basic, what you call, it's a slope that we use in addition to the covariance that is mentioned above. Okay, so we need to interpret all these things. This interpretation should be explained in 150 words. Okay, we copy this table. What we do is, like, we take this design, print screen. Want to write anything about this design, we name it, then we copy and paste this from this results, this maybe this one. We paste it here, and sorry, let us paste it in Excel sheet, and we copy it from Excel sheet. Okay, so I will open another sheet. So here it is, and we should name all those things. Quotient, standard error. Standard quotient. Tolerance, t-stat, t-value, code. Okay, so these are the values. On the p value, I will be filtering it. Okay. This is stable. It follows by your explanation about linear regression analysis. So you can discuss how you create a linear regression, and you can discuss what are the values. You can discuss about p-value and its importance. Then you can discuss about coefficients. You can discuss about intercept. Okay, so using all these values, you just explain how this correlation is influence. So to create correlation equations, sorry, linear regression equation, you use all these things. For example, intercept value, so this is 36.52284 plus or minus all these values into their attribute value. Means, so for example, if you want to write a linear equation, it will be 36.52 minus I stat into 0.52863 plus RM into, so this 3.826 something minus 1.486 into DIS minus 0.949 into PT ratio minus 17.69 into NYX value plus 0.325 into RAD value. In that way we write. Okay, so you just focus on that thing. All right, thank you guys. Finish it properly. It is just 150 words, not more than that. Thank you.